Right, well, good morning. Time at the moment is 5:47. Alarm went off at 4:30. We had to walk the kayak a mile because the van's still broken, but that's a story for another day. You would have heard it a few times by now. And we're out today on the Sussex Slam trying to catch a bass. Now, low tide is at 8 o'clock. This area does really well. It's about a mile away where we've got to go, so we're going to make the paddle down there. We're going to go for bass for about 3 or 4 hours. A few are coming up on lures at the moment on the beach reports, so there's definitely bass there which are hungry. A few mackerel are coming out, and obviously the bass chase the mackerel. So that's what we're up for today. We're going to go for some bass. When the tide changes and starts on the flood, we'll do about 30 minutes still trolling for bass. But after that, if we've not had any luck, or if we have had luck quickly, we're going to go out to my marked spot where we hopefully, who never know, get a chance of a Dover sole, some rays, dogfish, some early larger smoothhound maybe. So it's going to hopefully be a day of some really mixed fishing. I'm going to put two lure rods out to my mark now, because if there's no rods in the water, you're not fishing. We're going to put some feathers on at anchor as well, try and get some mackerel, because a lot have been coming up Seaford Way at the moment and Hove. And it's just the start of May. It's literally, I think it's the 1st of May today, or 29th of April. So I don't really know. I don't know dates, okay? Don't quiz me on dates, but it's nearly May, possibly May. Right, I've got about 45 minute paddle. The tide is with me, so that's nice. Thank you for joining us. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't. Give it a thumbs up and give it a comment below. Thank you very much and welcome to the journey. Right, so we're coming into the bassing area now. I've just spotted two cormorants diving down, so that's a really good sign. When the cormorants are diving, it means there's fish. The birds know a hell of a lot more than us, and I will follow them. If I see them diving out a mile out, I'll follow them, you know, because that is where the fish are. They've got thousands of eyes in the air, and you think about a drone over a carp lake or a drone over anything, you think you can see it, you can see so much down there. That's exactly what it is for them. Right, so we're at anchor. I've just geared all the rods up. We're going to send a whole bluey out with a pennel style, just ledger. Whole bluey, and we'll put a whole squid on, and we'll see if we can get that bass. Likely get a few rays as well, hopefully. But yeah, we want a bass for the slam, so that's what we're after. Well, this first little place of the day. It's got about an hour now till low, so I'm not expecting any bites for a sort of an hour or two, really. But yeah, just a little place. Well, I don't know if you can see that, bit of line. Spider crabs, I think, so we could have a problem with those. Hopefully as the tide sort of rushes through the flood, maybe they'll disappear, but we'll just tie a new hook up and do one. We're in. I was just pulling in my rods because I was going to go and do some bass fishing again, and I thought, oh, it's a bit quiet. Oh, this could be a lovely fish. Oh, this could be a big fish, guys. Look at that rod bending. This is taking some line as well. Oh, this could be good. Oh, on a whole bit of squid. I was going to go do a bass fishing, but maybe I won't now. Maybe I will stay at anchor. But here she comes. Oh my goodness, this is a lovely ray. Yes! Look at that ray. Gorgeous. Look at that ray. Lovely. She's lovely, actually. She's a female. There she goes. So it's about 50 centimetres, that one. Back down she goes.
I suppose we'll stay at anchor.
Another little place. Got the calf. I reckon that's... I don't know if sea fish can do hybrid, but underneath it's really dark. Normally they're white underneath. Strange. Definitely a place. But with a really dark bottom. Strange. Get her back. We're in. I don't think it's a ray. If it is a ray, it's going to be a really small one. Ah, no, it's a spider crab. Now, if you want to catch these spider crabs, you need to keep them in the water. And then, because as soon as they feel air, they'll let go. So this one possibly won't let go because he's very try and quickly swing him in, but I'll try and grab him and show you what they are. There we go. So you can use these as bait, but that one is hugging, as you can see. That is what is ruining our baits. We're in, and this is not a spider crab. Oh, she's taking line. This is on a big bit of squid. I can still feel it thudding, donk, donk, donk. Oh. Oh, this is a fun hobby, isn't it? Oh, right, here we go. Woohoo! What a lovely girl. Get her measured. Oh, look at that ray. That is probably near, I reckon, about 8 pounds. That's a little... Yeah, it's over a 4 kilo weight. I think if I was shoulder at the gym, that would feel more than that. So we just had that ray, and I was just winding in the lug rod. Another little place. Little dogfish. Obligatory dogfish. Yeah, I don't mind them actually. When the fishing is relatively quiet, I quite like them. A few little knocks on the rod, and that sort of indicates dogfish. Just little tap, 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 and that's what it was. Yeah, just a little dogfish. Quite nice. I'm happy with that. I'm happy with any fish, to be honest with me. Little dogfish. See you later. It's typical, isn't it? You're just about to get your lunch out, and you get a few nibbles. But I'm going to have some hummus and some celery and some carrots, I think. But you would have known that because I showed it in the intro. Beautiful day to be out. Very lucky indeed. Look at that bending the rod, here we go, boom, we're in, oh, very good fun this, oh, this is fun, oh, come on, big ray, oh, I like it when they start coming up in the water, unfortunately, oh no, double take, oh dear, the other rod's going now, oh no, a double take, oh my goodness. Oh, goodness me, this fish is nowhere near here. Right, it's coming, it's sort of coming, oh god, I've got another bite now. Damn it. Oh god, double take, this could be fun. This could be fun. Double take! Look, the other rod's going, oh no! Double take! Right, there we go. Right, that male's on board. Oh my god, third take. Oh god, third take. We've got a massive bite on there with a streaming line out on the reel. And we've got this rod going. Ah, mayhem. Let's do this one first. Oh my god. Right, here we're in. Oh, look, that rod's going. That rod is absolutely diving. Right, I've loosened the gear on that one. And then we've got a third, we've got another fish on here. Oh my life, why does it all have to happen at once? Right, this could be a ridiculous, oh my god, there's a huge take on that tiny spinning rod with lugworm. Oh my goodness me. I'm just having to pump this one, get this one in the boat quickly. There we go. Here she comes. Ah! There she's in. Right. Two rays on our lap and another rod going. Ready? Oh. Yeah, we're in again. God, this is mental. Oh. Right, what I'm going to do, I'm going to let this one go, but I'm going to let the gear go, I'll put that in its rod holder and I'll deal with these rays first because I don't really want them out of the water. Clutter down here. Alright. Stop in harbour talking nonsense. Not nonsense, they've got their job to do, haven't they? Alright, let's have a little look. Alright, let's put that one down there. Let me unhook this one here. Oh, she's a lovely fish. Alright, that one's done. Good. Alright, that's one. Why does it happen all at once? You know, there's no... Literally, all those three rods all went off within about 2 minutes. All right, hang on. So that's a lovely male as well. I wonder if we want to get a picture of that, but at the same time, I'm not going to... Right, that one's gone. Sort that rod out. Get that rod over there. That's good. Right, I'll put the male down there for a second and then try and sort this one out. Because now I thought this was a single hook, but obviously I've put a peddled on it. Right, I'm gonna get this sorted and then we're gonna try for that one. Right, guys, we've got heave and ho. Two rays and a ray on my spinning rod there. So we've got a little female, pop her back, and a lovely big male. 50, same as the others. So we'll get her back, or him, sorry, that one. She's got penis. And then we'll get on to this one. Right, here we go. Let's see if we've lost it, or it's probably taken me to bloody Hastings. Right, here we go, we're in. This is absolutely ludicrous. Three runs within the space of a minute. Literally, this is incredible. I would drop that other rod down, but I'll be silly too, because they'll probably all go at once, and then I'm buggered. This rod will take me probably 5 minutes to get her in. So I'm gonna turn off the camera, and when my third ray is on board, I'll show you him or her. Beautiful fish. So lucky to be out today. Wow, look at that, guys. Look at that, you can see her in the water. Wow, look at that. Now that could be a PB. Wow, look at her. Whoa. Wow. Right, I'm going to measure
56 centimetres.
Beautiful fish. Absolutely stunning. Let's get her back. Look at her. There she goes. Yes! Right, I'm going to bait up all three rods because they all need to go out. A triple hit. When do you get that? Red letter day.
Well, I've left this one out here a little bit longer and we've got a dogfish. Hey, little dogfish. See you later, Mr. Dogfish. I actually really like them, they've got good personalities on them. Ready? Go on then. See you later.
Right, that's wee stop done. We're gonna put the life jacket back on, sort out this dry suit.